This is a vinyl record cut by me from the all analogue era, no digits involved. And the resolution of this record is at least four times that of CD. Think of pixels. CD.
Never.
Never. You have to pick a number. You say, how many samples do you need for accurate reproduction of a waveform? I would say probably a minimum of 10 samples. So you've got a sort of sound wave there, and you need to sample it quite a lot to work out the shape of that wave, right? And if you say 10 samples from there to there, one cycle, yeah
okay, I understand that,
yeah? Well, 44.1, 10 samples is 4k.
Okay.
So by my book, the John Dent book of how to record music, a CD is only accurate up to about 4 kilohertz. Everything else, it makes it up. It's an invention, because if you have 10 kilohertz on a CD, that's only 4 samples. So where do you take the samples? Here, there, there. How do you know the shape of that waveform? That waveform could be this shape. And you wouldn't know it because of the sampling. So when you work at 2496, you see 10k is now 9.6 samples, nearly 10. So 2496 is better than 441. But with analog, there's no sampling. The cutting systems can be flat to beyond 50 kilohertz. They may not be linear beyond 25 kilohertz, but they at least put the frequencies on there. And they're pure, they're pure tones.